go.
For the night, dog. What are y'all talking about?
Let me tell you something.
Is it being canceled?
We didn't get it.
How am I being canceled? I love my playtime.
Hold on, wait. Is school excused?
Worst quarterback in 5A. He got favorites.
Don't tell you, we got
number one got favorites, bro. He got favorites.
My friend out here.
Just to let y'all know, I haven't gotten the game to the second quarter, but I'm straight, dog. I'm just letting my boys out there do their thing.
Be able to shine.
All right, now as a linebacker, I've seen you in scouting reports, I've seen you in the games, practice, where you're able to call out plays. Have you ever always been like that?
I've always been a student of the game. I just pick up on tendencies, stay studying in the film, and that's where it all comes together.
Now, do you study that on your own time, or are you studying that while you're at practice?
I'm studying this while I'm in class, before I go to sleep. All that.
All right, so within the recruitment process, how's it going right now?
Right now I have 2 scholarship offers from Norfolk State and Virginia State, and I'm still open to anything, but I just want to find somewhere where I can fit in academically and athletically.
Okay, you know what you're doing.
Hey, y'all put your tables up.
Chemistry or mechanical engineering.
You trying to go and play linebacker? Is that the position you're trying to stay at?
Wherever the coach puts me at.
So now we got Javeon Smalls. Just picked up 3 offers, 1 recently from North Carolina Central. So let me ask you this. What do you think is one of the main reasons that Central looked to get an offer? What is it that you think they saw in him?
I feel like they said the coach called me and told me to watch my film, and he said that he really liked my effort and what I was doing. See, even when I'm not getting the ball and I am getting the ball, he still likes my effort, and I'm always going 100% off the ball.
Now, being an athletic and speedy receiver, do you think your speed plays a major part in how successful you are as a receiver?
Most definitely. I feel like it plays a part because I feel like a lot of DBs can't really stick with me like that because my feet just move too fast.
And you're a big receiver, so you're not small. Now, let me ask you this. What's going to be the determining factor when you decide where you do want to play college ball? Is it immediate play time? Is it the location of the school? Is it the academic programs? What's going to be that determining factor for you?
When I determine, I really want to turn on my academics because that's always going to come first before anything. And I really want to just focus on business and just make a lot of money.
All right, and for the remainder of the year, what do you want to see out of yourself for the remainder of the year? Do you have any personal goals, or do you just have some straight team goals for the rest of the year?
Just straight team goals. I want all us to accomplish what we want to do. Everybody go to college and just focus on what they got to do.
So now we got Malcom Green. He's picked up 21 offers since April 30th, 2018. He is a cornerback. He's a lockdown corner. And he's a junior. Now, Malcom, I have a question. You got 21 offers in, that's about 6 months. What do you think are some of the main reasons that colleges are looking for you or are providing you offers? Like, what separates you from other defensive backs?
I feel like what separates me from other defensive backs is that I just love to tackle and I'm good at man coverage, so I'm relentless. And I got to
make plays always.
All right, so when you getting all these offers and stuff like that, I'm pretty sure with it being a social media era, what are all these people in school saying to you? How do you block it out?
People in school congratulate me a lot, but I always know that it's always a negative side to what people say sometimes too. So I don't read comments and stuff like that in the DM. I leave stuff unread, but if it's people that I know, I'll read it and show love back. Always.
All right, so as far as determining your school that you're going to further your education, what's the deciding factor that you're looking for that's going to help you with selecting your school?
The deciding factor would be a team that just has an environment that's like a family. Everyone shows love for each other, cares for each other, wants the best. Everyone want to work hard and just a winning environment. Everybody got the same common goal to win.
All right, so y'all got a solid secondary of Highland Springs. Cornerbacks are locked down, the safeties are locked down. Do you feel that if you could take away a part of anybody's game in that secondary, who would it be and what would you take away?
So like if I could take a part of anybody's game, it would be probably Tremayne Talbert.
And what would you take away from him?
He's a ball hawk, so he always around with the ball being thrown. So I just take away those opportunities that he has. I wish I could have the same and just go for the ball like he do.
So now we got David Laney, opposing corner of Malcom Green, who we prior interviewed. And David, so I have a question. How many offers do you have currently?
I currently have 3 offers from UVA, Purdue, and Louisville.
All right, so those are 3 big D1 offers, and they are all for defensive backs, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right, so is this your first full year playing defensive back?
Yes, this is my first full year.
All right, so you got 3 D1 offers your first full year within the first, 4 or 5 games?
Yeah.
All right, so what do you think were the reasons or deciding factors that those schools decided to offer you?
They all told me that they like my size, and of last year's film, when I stepped in for Tremayne Talbert at a corner, and they said they liked me coming up to make a hit and me being a ball hawk and going to go get the ball.
All right, now with Tremayne Talbert being injured last year, now he's back, did you take anything away from his game, or you know, what was your mindset when you came in let's say week 7, and then you made a huge impact on varsity last year?
When I came in, I always looked at T-Man on the field, and I liked like his swagger on the field, how he was always like vocal to his teammates, always talked to him, and then how he always flew around to the ball, like if it's in the air or like tackling somebody.
All right. And with your deciding factor to further your education, what's going to be one of the main factors that's going to determine where you're going to go next year? After your senior year.
The main factor is it's got to feel like home to me and my family, because I know that for me it's going to be a big like thing for me going into a 4-year college, so it needs to be a home for me.
Now, do you want to stick the corner on the next level, or are you open to making that transition to safety, or do you want to kind of stay at the cornerback position?
Honestly, to me it doesn't matter. I can play safety and corner.
Now we got Ali Jennings, wide receiver, class of 2019. So Ali, you just transferred to Highland Springs from Hermitage. What is the difference from Hermitage's program to Highland Springs' program? And how do you feel that your game has changed in the last year?
Just when I transferred over, I realized that it's more of a family over here, and we all like we compete every day to make each other better. So it's like game day. We're going against people who are not even on our level, because we compete every day. We just get better going against the best players in the area.
How do you think your game has improved from last year to this year?
My game has improved from releases, me exploding off the line, in and out of my routes, and I got my hands better and my speed as well.
All right, and you have 22 offers, correct?
Yes, sir.
Right, and of those 22 offers, what do you think is the main determining factor for those offers? Is it your size, your hands, your route running? What is it that you think are attracting a lot of the colleges?
It's my size, my ability to run routes, and my catching radius. I can catch anything that's in my range, and no catch is a hard catch for me. I believe that, and yeah, like me, my speed has gotten better as well, so I went from a 4.7 to a 4.5, so coaches are starting to notice that as well.
All right, and what do you do with having having so many offers, I know how it can be with a lot of athletes on opposing teams feeling away or feeling jealous. How do you go out and handle that? How do you block out a lot of that hearsay, especially with social media?
Yeah, a lot of people try and tell me that I'm overrated and people don't try and like give me my respect that I work for. So I just have to go out every Friday night or whenever we play and just show them how hard I work and who I really am.
All right, and with this recruitment process, because I'm pretty sure more offers are going to come in, what's some deciding factors that kind of make you feel at ease about the selection you're going to make, where you're going to decide to go to college?
The main deciding factors is the relationships I built with the coach and then other people in the organization as well, like the players, the GAs, everybody that works in the staff and goes, attends this college. Like, it just has to feel like I can relate to y'all and just feel at home. Like, I don't want to go somewhere and feel like, man, like, why did I come here? It was nothing how I thought it would be. So I want to just be somewhere where I can be comfortable.
So now we got Tremayne Talbert, safety, senior for Highland Springs. So T-Man, you played safety as well as receiver last year. You made a huge impact in the first 7 games. Now this year, you're making an even more tremendous impact. What's some of your, let's say, best traits on the offensive side of the ball and the defensive side of the ball?
The offensive side of the ball, it's easier because I play DB, so I know what a DB gonna do, so I do the opposite and get open and catch the ball.
All right, so when you got hurt last year, like what was your mindset? Were you just kind of like let down or like, you know what it is and I'm coming back strong next year?
Yeah, basically at that time I was kind of down, but then I knew that my guys was gonna finish the season off strong, so I was good.
All right, now my next question with college, you are, like all your other defensive backs to tell you, and I see it as well, you're a ball hawk. You react to the ball well, you fly to the ball, and you make plays. When you decide on where you're going to go to college, what's one of the main deciding factors that's going to play a role where you go?
I have to get into a winning organization. I can't come from 3-time, 4-time state champ to winning 2 games, so that's going to be a big impact on where I go.
Now, you're from Richmond, VA, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, where do you want to go to? If you had your choice, would you want to travel far from home or you want to stay close to home?
I'll get away from here ASAP.
All right. So now, my last question. You know, you're very well-spoken and you're outspoken, but when you're on the field, what do you think opposing players view as a T-man? Like, do they take you as a cocky demeanor? Do they think you're arrogant? Do they just think, you know, we got to kind of quiet him because he makes a lot of plays? What do you think players think about you on the opposing team?
I think they got to quiet me. They got to keep the ball out of my hands, basically. But they probably think I'm cocky or whatever, but I just play football.
we had to stay on y'all. Cause guess what? Ain't no problems on the field. All the problems are off the field. Y'all gotta mature quickly, man. Cause y'all time coming real soon to play on Friday nights under these lights. And if you ain't mature enough to do it, the opportunity won't be there. Trust me. Trust me, dog. Y'all got it?
Yes, sir.
Hey, there's not a team out here gonna play with us. We got no way we stay to do this, dog. All we gotta do is execute, baby. That's it. We gonna be straight, you know what I mean?
Yes, sir.
All right, hey, every coach up here, man, love y'all, proud of y'all, man. Got it, hey, it's our job to stay on y'all and don't let y'all breathe, dog. To get y'all right mentally, all right?
Yes, sir.
Coach, got anything you wanna say?
Hey, you see them foot in the weight room there, right?
Yes, sir.
We beat them down. We didn't beat them, we beat them down.
Yes, sir.
Hey, take this out, man. We can't end like that, right? Hey, Boogie, let's go, baby. Break us down. Let's go.
You gotta come to work. You understand? Hey, 40 straight wins, dog. I don't know about no other JV programs in the state doing that, but guess what? We can talk about ours. 40 straight wins, third undefeated season in a row. Fourth overall in the 6 years we've been doing this. You know what I'm saying? And we ain't finished, dog. Got more work to do. You know what I'm saying? Catch reality.
Come on. Come on. We will win. Because we will hit all game. We are motivated. We are dedicated.
Yes,
come on now.
Yes,
come on now. Yes, we will win because we are the best on the field.
Yes.
Then we hit the field like all day light, all night light, on the blue light, on fist light, defense light, his squad light, house call light, hit a sound light, hit a sound light, hit a sound light.
Hey, what I say? Hey, I told you we won't play with these little boys. This is a grown man.
front. Let's get it. Let me get my Westbrook on.
We love this though. This is what we love. Stop playing.
Cause I don't talk to you.
Leave him alone.